Hello, we are discussing about GATE 2012 ECE paper and it's a common data question for the next coming two questions. And look at the diagram, that is three-dimensional view of a silicon n-channel MOS transistor where the delta value is given as 20 nanometers, transistor width is 1 micrometer, depletion width formed at every p-n junction is 10 nanometer, relative permittivities of silicon and silicon dioxide are given. 11.7 and 3.9 and epsilon naught free space permittivity is also given. What we are going to calculate from the diagram is gate to source overlap capacitance. The value of gate to source overlap capacitance approximately out of these four options, the answer A is going to be the right answer. 0.7 femtofarad is the right answer. Okay, so look at this one, gate source overlap capacitance. If you are looking at this is three-dimensional pattern and this G implies nothing but this portion acting as gates and this is drain and this side is source. So this terminal is going to be acting as, which is acting as source. So whenever gate and gate drain, normally we will see the construction in this way, two-dimensional method. Every n-channel MOSFET is going to be fabricated under p-type substrate and into that one two n plus regions are going to be diffused. Okay, above that one a thin silicon dioxide is going to be placed, which is nothing but act as gate oxide. Above that one polysilicon is placed. This is what it is, polysilicon acting as gate and one of the n plus region is acting as source, the other is acting as drain. So this is what generally we will draw, but here what we do is nothing but gate and source are going to be not overlapped. But in practice, gate portion is going to be overlapped, overlapping the sum of the source as well as drain portions. So if you are looking at this portion, okay, this diagram, just look at this point. At this position, the gate area is going to be area of some gate, area of gate is going to be overlapped by delta length. So we can write like this. This is gate area. So it is gate, okay. And source is going to be over this way. This is acting as source. So n plus, this is source and it is p gate, polysilicon gate. So in between you will get some silicon dioxide layer. This is silicon dioxide layer. Okay, this thick line is nothing but thin oxide, which is nothing but silicon dioxide layer. So that if you are going to check this one, it looks like it is a conductor. Okay, this is plate 1, plate 1, okay, and this n plus is going to be acting as plate 2, and in between this line is nothing but SiO2 layer, which looks like parallel plate capacitor, parallel plate capacitor. So parallel plate capacitor is nothing but whose capacitance can be calculated by epsilon A by D. D is nothing but distance between the plates. Distance between the plates is nothing but, in this case, that is oxide thickness. Distance between the plates is nothing but oxide thickness. It was given as 1 nanometer. So this you can write it as epsilon naught into relative permittivity of silicon dioxide we should consider. Okay, relative permittivity of silicon dioxide, because the dielectric material is now silicon dioxide. So that relative permittivity of silicon dioxide we must consider, and this is TOX. TOX value is nothing but this one, 1 nanometer is nothing but TOX, that is width of that is thickness of silicon dioxide layer. So from this one C is going to be given as, and epsilon into A also we have to write. Area, A implies nothing but area of this portion. Area of this portion is nothing but how much it has been overlapped, that is delta, okay, into, in three dimension, what is its width? So delta into W. This is W. Okay, so delta into W in three dimensional pattern, how much it has been pronounced. So delta into W, which is nothing but delta value is 0.2. Delta value is it has given as delta value is 20 nanometer multiplied by width is nothing but 1 micrometer, and substitute this area, and epsilon naught is given, epsilon silicon dioxide is given, that is 3.9, and area is known, TOX is given as 1 nanometer, and you are going to get the exact value for this one is nothing but 0.7 femtofarad. Femto implies nothing but 10 power minus 15 farad. So the right option for this question is A. And the next question related to this same data is nothing but source body junction capacitance. Now look at this one. Body is also called as, the other name for the body is bulk, or it is also called as substrate. Body or bulk or substrate, all are going to be same. That implies nothing but source and substrate junction capacitance. The meaning of this one is nothing but we are going to calculate source substrate junction capacitance. If you are going to be looking at, for n channel, source must be of n plus type and substrate must be of p type. So that is, it looks like a p-n junction is going to be forming or not. So it is looking like a p-n junction is going to be taking place across source substrate as well as drain substrate also, because drain is also of n plus nature. So that there will be a p-n junction formed across source substrate as well as drain substrate. Here we are going to calculate source substrate junction capacitance. By that time, visualize this source. This is the area of source, that is, this is the source portion, and this source portion, if you visualize, it is dipped into p-type substrate. Okay, this source area, source is going to be dipped into p-type substrate, such that the left and right of source area is going to be in the p-type substrate, and front and back is also in the substrate, okay, along with bottom. That implies nothing but if you are going with a rectangular three-dimensional waveform, three-dimensional pattern of rectangular rectangle, at that time source is in that way. It will have six faces except for the top. All other faces, that is left and right, front and back and bottom, all will be in connection with substrate. So that if you want to calculate capacitance at that time, you must consider all those five faces. Okay, you can understand that one with the help of this diagram. So now look at this one. This is what specially we are going with. This is source. Source will be having six faces. If you are assuming that source is going to be a rectangular pattern in three dimension. So out of that one, except for the top, okay, except for the top, all are going to be in connection with substrate. So that these are, first one is nothing but left, and third one is nothing but right, and fourth one is front, second one is back, and fifth one is bottom. These five faces we have to consider. Okay, and in these five faces, this is nothing but 0.2 micrometers. This is the value. What you are going to consider is nothing but this is 0.2 micrometers what was given, and whose width of this one is nothing but 1 micrometer, and this height is also of 0.2 micrometers. Every dimension is known to us. Okay, now we are going to calculate source substrate junction capacitance. Source substrate junction capacitance can be written as, okay, source substrate, which is nothing but body junction capacitance. Again, it is going to be looks like a p-n junction under reverse bias, because source is going to be given more positive voltage than substrate. So that this is junction capacitance, which is nothing but reverse bias p-n junction. So whose capacitance can be calculated by using epsilon A by D. Here epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught into epsilon R. Relative permittivity of silicon we have to consider, because we are considering source as well as substrate, both are of silicon type. Okay, so that we are going for the epsilon R of silicon divided by into area divided by D. D is nothing but width of depletion region formed is 10 nanometers. It was given width of depletion region formed across every p-n junction is going to be 10 nanometer. That was given. Epsilon naught is also given. Epsilon R of silicon is also given. Okay, so what else we are going to calculate is nothing but only A is unknown. Area area can be calculated with the help of 5 different faces. So for all these 5 faces we have to calculate area. So that implies nothing but area of 4 walls plus area of bottom is going to be treated as total area. So area of 4 walls, 4 walls is nothing but in that one the 1 and 3 are going to be identical, so that you can write 2 times of only one area you can consider, that is third area, that is nothing but 0.2 micro into 1 micro plus 2 times of the other 2 walls, 2 and 4 are identical, so that you can consider 2, area of 2 is you can write it as 0.2 micro plus multiplied into 0.2 micro plus bottom, only bottom is nothing but one area, bottom is 1, so that 1 multiplied by, okay, what we are going with is nothing but bottom is 0.2 into 1. So if you add all these things, area is going to be equal to 0.68 micrometer square, 0.68 micrometer square. So total area substituted in the capacitance equation is going to be 0.68 micrometers. Next, if you substitute that one along with the known values of epsilon naught and epsilon r of silicon, then you are going to be getting capacitance is equal to 7 femtofarad. 7 femtofarad, that is nothing but 7 into 10 power minus 15 farads. So this is the answer for the source body junction capacitance. That is the right answer for this one is nothing but B. Thank you.